Hallelujah! Glory be to God forever in the name of Jesus Christ. Welcome, all believers, fellow believers in the Lord. God bless you today in the name of Jesus. This is a discipleship baby class, you can say, or discipleship first class. I'm talking still today about this is number four lesson I'm giving concerning the creation, how God created man. I said in the beginning, I was explaining in the beginning that God created man in his own image. I talk about Genesis 1 and the book of John 1, because that is the only two books that was written that there in the beginning. And so from there we saw how God created everything. Then I explained in the second lesson that even though God is the one that created everything, but he himself was not created. He created everything, but he himself was not created. Nobody knows when God started to exist, but he started to create the heavens and the earth and all this, all the creation and everything, the angels. And then from there he created man. And that was just the beginning of the creation that he was creating things. But that is not when God himself started to exist. God started to exist. Nobody knew when he started to exist. He is, the Bible called him eternal God. He is from ages to ages, everlasting God. So I explain about that. And I talk about how God created the light and call it day, and God created also darkness and divided with the darkness and call it night. You know, so I also explained what in First Thessalonians 5 verse 5, that if you read there the new covenant, they say that there's a children of the day and children of the night and children of darkness and children of light, you know. So that was the differentiation that God differentiates. So we can see that these are different personalities. You know, children of day, children of night, and is different personalities. So children of the day and children of the light are people who come from Jesus Christ, because Jesus Christ is the light of the world. And children of night and children of darkness are children of the devil, because the devil is darkness. His kingdom is the kingdom of darkness. The Bible says God has redeemed us from the kingdom of darkness and brought us to his own marvelous kingdom of light. Amen. So I was talking also here about Genesis. I explained about Genesis 6, that God even pronounced after Adam and Eve their sin in the garden, because they were deceived by the devil and they eat of the forbidden fruit, which was not allowed for them to eat. God reduced their years to 120 years. There was the fruit of life in the garden, but they did not go to take the fruit of life. They would have lived forever, but they disobeyed God and now took the fruit of the knowledge of good and evil. And then God pronounced a curse on them that they will stay only 120 years. So in Genesis 6, God says that his spirit cannot always strive with man, because man is just flesh, because he discovered that man is wicked continuously. So he says that man will live only 120 years. And the devil will deceive them. The Lord pronounced that the seed of this woman will crush the head of the devil. So that is Jesus Christ that God was pronouncing. That was a prophecy. So from there, Genesis 6, God started to look a way how to redeem man. He first even killed the first animal in the garden to cover man's nakedness, because they were naked. The glory of God that was in them, which is called the life light, which, according to the book of John 1, left them. And now the dead spirit, the nature of the devil, came and lived in that container that is called Adam. You know, Adam was made in God's image, but God used the ground from the earth of the soil and mold Adam and breathe the life, his own life and light inside Adam, his own essence. That is when the Bible says that man became a living soul, and God created man in his own image. I explained the other video, I think in the lesson 2, I talk about how the nature of God and the nature of man, how man and God relate and how the nature is. I explain about that. If you have not watched the video, you can go and watch the other lesson. I think it's the lesson 2 or lesson 3. You can check there in the name of Jesus Christ. So I explained that when man sinned, now they were driven out of the garden. You know, they were driven out of the garden. And then from there, God start to look now for a way to redeem man. He first pronounced that the seed of this woman, Eve, will crush the head of the devil. That devil will deceive them. And then from there, God started to look for a way to come into the earth and redeem man, because the Bible says that the heaven is the God's throne and the earth is his footstool, you know. So he gave this earth for the sons of men, for the people who are made with flesh and blood, you know. So he gave it to the earth. So he was looking now for a way to come and redeem them. So he came, he first started to make covenants, you know, how to enter, because he wants to make this relationship, to build this relationship back and to reconcile back with man. And but that could not be done without judgment. It has to be done with judgment, because man has sinned. The Bible says the wages of sin is death, but the free gift of God is eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ. So now, God first made the first covenant with Noah. Noah and the seed of Noah, because in the end that time, the devil and his demons, they came and start sleeping with the human beings and start to produce it, and they pollute the whole earth. So all the whole earth is, it was a mixed breed. You know, if you see Goliath in the book of First Samuel, you will see Goliath with six fingers and six toes. Those are the giants that were born that time, from half spirit of demons and half human. So that time God did not like that idea. So he decided to flood the whole earth. You know, the only family that was, the only one man that was righteous was Noah. And then Noah now was the only one that God instructed him and said, go and build an ark and take two animals and live in that ark. So in that ark, Noah built the ark according to the commandment of God, took his family and took also the animals, all animals in the earth, two, with crops and everything, and enter into that ark. And then God flood the whole earth and destroy all the human race. So only Noah and his children, they were saved. Noah had three children, which I explained also in the other distance, Shem, Japheth, and Ham. They were the three children. One of them was cursed because he saw the father nakedness. And then the other two were blessed. Noah blessed them. In the name of Jesus, Noah bless them. So now this this family where was blessed, that is Shem and Japheth, that is where the lineage of Abraham came. So God make a covenant first with Noah, and then later he made a covenant. He now made a covenant with Abraham. Today I want to talk a little bit about the Abrahamic covenant that God make with Abraham, which we call now the Old Covenant. You know, so this old covenant, when God chose Abraham, Abraham was 70 years. Abraham was a worshiper of Son, the family they worship Son. So God now called Abraham out of his father's house and said, I'll go to where I want you to go, was in the land of Canaan. I will direct you to go there. Go there. And with your, so Abraham took his wife and his nephew, which is his brother's son. The brother died. He took his son. His son name was Lot. Took these two people and then went now as God directed him. So he left now and started to follow this Most High God. He doesn't know. So Abraham believed God. The Bible says he trusted God and believed God. And he just went to a place that he never ever knew. If you read the book of Hebrews 11, it's explaining that. So God counted that for righteousness. And he went now to this Canaan land and started to live there, make intent. You know, from there they went to Egypt. Things were, you know, there was famine in the land. They decided to go to Egypt with the wife, you know. Then later they came back again from Egypt, and when they came back, they brought a lot of cattle and a lot of stuff and many things, you know. And when they came back, the Lot cattlemen, because Lot had his own blessing too through Abraham, he got a lot of cattle and sheep and gold and silver. All of them were very, very rich. So they came to this place where it was a big land, and then the Bible says that Abraham cattle men and Lot cattle men, they were fighting because of land, you know. So from there, Abraham told Lot and say, we don't need to fight, we are brothers, you know. This land is big, so choose your own place where you want to go. If you want to take the right, take the right, I will go to the left. If you want to take the left, take the left, I'll now go to the right. So that is how he told him. And then from there, the Bible says that Lord looked on top of that site of Sodom and Gomorrah. It was green and nice. It looks like Egypt, where they were coming from. He chose that site. So he decided to go to Sodom and Gomorrah to go live there. So immediately that was the time that God now started to speak now to Abraham. Because they say almost how many years, for a very long time, God was not talking to Abraham again. You know, so from there, he started to say, okay, Abraham, you are my... if you see here... In the Genesis 15, you know, you read here in Genesis 15, that was when now they say after all these things, because even Genesis 14 also explain the fight that the kings of Sodom and Gomorrah came to fight Abraham and took up no fight up a Lot, you know, to fight the whole Sodom and Gomorrah, and took Lot, the Abraham's nephew, and also his goods. So Abraham took his men from his house, 300 and something men, to go and fight those kings, and then he retrieved Lot and all Lot's goods. You know, it's written all there in Genesis 15. If you read now Genesis 15 is explaining now. That was where now God now appeared again out to Abraham and told Abraham and say, after the Bible say, after all these things, if you just start from the beginning, verse 1, after these things, the word of the Lord now came now to Abraham, because his name has not changed yet. His name was just Abraham, you know, before God started to give him the promise. After they had the covenant, then God made a promise with him and changed his name to Abraham, which is mean father of many nations. So now his name was just Abraham. They say God came to Abraham in a vision saying that, fear not, Abraham, I am your shield and exceeding great reward. And then from there, God starts to speak with Abraham. Abraham starts to tell him and say, look, I know you are my shield, you are my exceeding great reward, but I don't have a child. I have servants in my house. I have many servants, 300 and something. And this Eliza is the one from Damascus who will be here, you know. I don't want him to be here. So he was asking God, say, what will you give me? You know, you have promised me, I trust you, I love you, what will you give me? So from there, God told him that and said this man will not be your head. This man will not be your head. Then God took him out and showed him, if you read verse 5, he said, God brought him forth abroad and said unto him, look towards the heaven. And he said, tell the stars if you are able to number them. And he said unto him, so shall your seed be. And then the Bible says Abraham believed God. Abraham believed God in verse 6, and it was counted for him for righteousness. God showed him the stars in the heaven and said, so is your seed going to be. So this man will not be your heir. The child that will come from your own bowels will be your heir. That is the one who will be your heir. So he was talking about the lineage of Jesus Christ still. So from there, God now told them, Abraham asked God and said, okay, how will I believe that I will take this land? And what you told me, how will I believe that all what you've told me is true? So God now told Abraham now to get some animals to make a sacrifice. So that was when they made the covenant in Genesis 15. They said to take a heifer of 3 years, and take a goat of 3 years, and take a ram of 3 years, take a young turtle dove and a young pigeon. And then he said he took all this and divided it into half pieces, and then he put this bird, and the bird he did not divide into half. So now the fowls of the air came, you know, which is Satan and his kingdom. They came now to disturb this covenant that God wants to make with Abraham. They start to come now to eat from there. Then they say Abraham drove them away. So yeah, go, 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 you know, leave this place, you know. So, and then they said a deep sun came, very deep sun. The sun came and covered everywhere. The sun came down, deep sleep fell on Abraham, and the horror of darkness fell in that place. And then the Bible said that Abraham now knew for surety that the Bible says that, and he said unto Abraham, know it for surety that the seed, their seed shall be a stranger in a strange land. That was the children of Israel that will go to Egypt to captivate them. In a strange land, they will save there, and they will afflict them there for 400 years. And also the nations whom they will save, I will judge. And also afterward, they will come out with great substance. And you shall also go to your father in peace, and you shall be buried in a good old age. So now the Bible says that in verse 17 says that, then came to pass when the sun was now down, there was dark, it was dark, there came a smoking furnace of a burning lamb, and then passed through all those pieces of those animals that Abraham caught like that. And then the Bible says that in that same day, the Lord made a covenant with Abraham, saying that unto your seed have I given this land, from the river of Egypt unto the great river, the river of Ephrates. And then he said, all the Canaanites, all the Hittites, the Perizzites, the Jebusites, all this land I've given it unto you. So that was when God made this covenant with Abraham. You know, in those days, people do covenant in different ways, you know. In those days, people do different type of covenant. Why God decided to make covenant with Abraham in this way to show, because that in those days Abraham knew about this covenant, because they were worshippers of some, you know, so they know how to do covenant. Sometimes they did covenant with blood, they joined their wrists together with each other, they cut with the knife and put the blood, mix it together, they joined in their names together. And all Abraham was a covenant man, he had a covenant mentality. That was why God wanted to make a covenant, to know that. So when he entered this covenant with Abraham, he knew that there is no other way that God can come out of this covenant, or he himself can come out of this covenant, except death. Death is only death that could divide or could cancel this covenant that he have with God. So you can imagine that kind of stuff. And then God told Abraham to make a sign by circumcising all his children and those of his household. That was the sign of that covenant, that all the men children in the house should be circumcised. They should cut them, their foreskin. That was removing the flesh of deity, you know, their foreskin. That was the sign of that covenant, you know. So you can even, if you see, you read the book of 1 Samuel 17 and to 26 to 39, you see how David was giving assurance to, was making assurance to Saul, telling Saul that your servant will kill this Goliath. In the book of he went, he said, I will kill this Goliath. He was very sure that he will slay that Goliath. Because why? Because of the covenant that he has with God. That covenant was the covenant that God made with Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, that continuity today that Jesus Christ now established to become a new and everlasting covenant. But at that time, the covenant was guilty because God made this Abraham with him and his descendants. You know, he made it. That's why David said here, he said, who is this uncircumcised Philistine? Because that circumcision was a sign to show that they are a covenant people, they are clean people, they are chosen people. That was a sign of that circumcision. When they circumcised themselves, that was a sign. So that was why he was asking the Goliath, said, who is this uncircumcised Philistine that want to come and defy the armies of the living God? You know, so he was showing this covenant. I have a covenant with God, and God will fight for us. And that is what happened, what he said. And God slay that Philistine. He killed that Philistine. He said, I can kill you, of course, you know, I can kill you. So now there is no better covenant. Jesus Christ is the one that has established now a better covenant. The Bible says a new covenant, because this old covenant God made with Abraham and his descendants, God said that they did not keep the covenant. They did not keep the covenant, because he made the covenant. They made all the promises. They established this covenant. They established their relationship together, which could not be broken except through penalty. So he told them they will inherit the land. You know, they will take the land. They will get that place. Everything. That is why when you read Galatians today, you hear that Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law by becoming a curse for us. Because curse is everyone who hung on the tree, so that the blessing which he promised to Abraham is because of this covenant. The promise he promised to Abraham and his descendant, you know, and all of us who are now Gentiles have come through Jesus Christ. We are also now profiting through this covenant. If you read Galatians, all these books explain a lot about it in the name of Jesus Christ. So covenant, you know, in those days they used to do exchange, you know. In those days when they make covenant, you see people, they exchange their power, you know. If they make covenant, they exchange their name. Sometimes they join their names together. Sometimes they even exchange their authority. If one have a more authority, for example, one is the one who owns, have a lot of connections, you know, then the other one have farm, you know, with food. So they exchange, you know, this one will use the armory, this one they have armory, they'll be using the emery. This other one will say, we'll provide the other people with food, you know. So that is how they used to exchange. At that time, they used to exchange their strength, you know. They exchange their enemies, even become the enemy. If one person have an enemy, it becomes the enemy of the other. So that is how it is with us today. If we have an enemy in the body of Christ, it is God's enemy, because we have a covenant with God. In the name of Jesus Christ. Sometimes that time, in those days when they do that blood, they cut those animals like that, they put out that blood will be rolling like in a trail like that. They will walk on that blood. That is what they call the way of the blood, you know. They will walk on the blood, and then also they will put their wrists, cut their wrists, like, you know, mix their blood together. That means that all what they are pronouncing, they cannot come out from this covenant. Then they will pronounce the blessing of the covenant, then they'll pronounce the curses. They'll pronounce the blessing in the sense that if they, if any of their people break the covenant, the curses will follow them. And if they keep the covenant, the blessing will follow. That is why if you read Deuteronomy 28, it explains that also, you know, the covenant that God made with Abraham and his descendants. You will see there, they say, if you keep this law, you will receive the blessing. If you don't keep it, these are the curses that will follow you. So that was the high. They will swear to their God, you know, then the third party, then they will make this covenant. And from there, with this blood, they will mingle the blood together. They'll join their family names, and then they'll make a permanent sign. They'll become one. And finally, they will eat now the covenant meal. When they do in those days, that's how they do. Then they'll kill the animal that they use to do about with the blood, with this blood covenant. They'll kill the animal. They'll make bread and they'll make wine. So the wine and the bread is the covenant meal that they do eat. That is what is called the covenant meal, what we eat today, the body and the blood of Jesus Christ. That is the covenant meal that signifies that they are now willing, they are have the willingness now together, now to lay down their lives for each other. Then they'll eat together, and then they share their strength, they share their weapons, they share food, they share names, everything. That is how the covenant is. You know, so by making the blood covenant with Abraham, God Almighty now proved that he wanted to exchange his strength, his weapon, and his authority with Abraham. And that is what happened. And that is what he did, you know. So I will continue in the next chapter to explain more a little bit about the covenant, how he got extend this covenant now to with the children of Israel, with Israel. Yeah, how he also met, how did they call him? Met Isaac and told Isaac that I have a covenant with your father. He met also Israel again and told Israel, which is Jacob, that I have a covenant with your father. So that is how God introduced himself and keep telling them, look, I have a covenant with Abraham and you are the descendant of Abraham and you people have to keep this covenant. So that is how the thing continues. So the covenant, that is why God, you can hear God says that I'm the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, is because of that covenant. So everything is because of that covenant, because he wanted his seed, Jesus Christ, to pass through that lineage and be born here on earth so that he can crush the head of the devil and to redeem us from the forces of the Satan and his kingdom. Because when Adam sinned, it caused this high treason. The lease that was given to the human race, Adam sold it to the devil. And then the devil and his agents and his demons, they are the rulers. The Bible called them the gods of this world and the rulers of this world. So they sold that lease to the devil. So that is why you see how the devil told Jesus Christ and say, if you bow down and worship me, all the kingdoms of this earth belongs to me. I will give it unto you. But Jesus Christ said, get thee behind me, Satan. You say, you must worship the Lord your God. Only him shall you save. You know, because Jesus Christ came now to die, to redeem us from the hand of the devil. That is why they say anyone that sin is sin from the beginning. And that is why the Son of God was manifested, to destroy the works of the devil. So Jesus Christ have to come through this lineage, through Abraham lineage, to born here on earth. So I'll be explaining about that in the next chapter, to explain how he visited Isaac, he visited Jacob, and then to introduce himself about this covenant. And then he made the law now. He gave the law to Moses for the children of Israel. And then now he continued to establish this covenant with David. And then Jesus Christ came through the lineage of David. And then now Jesus Christ established the new and everlasting covenant with us in the name of Jesus. So you see how the whole process is. So God has now an access to enter into the earth and to save the human race and to redeem his family, his lost family back that was lost, which is Adam and his wife, in the name of Jesus Christ. So God is amazing how he makes covenant with men. He made covenant just with Abraham, who is just a man, human being. That is how today, if you believe Jesus Christ, God will make a covenant with you through the blood of his son, and you will be saved in the name of Jesus. I hope you get something, new believers, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, because of the covenant that God has with Abraham. That is why all the Gentile world, all of us are saved in the name of Jesus Christ. Anyone that believes in Jesus Christ, the seed of David, we shall be saved, because because the Bible says anyone that believes in Christ is Abraham's seed, and you are joined here according to the promise. So that is so through this covenant of Abraham, that is why God could come to the earth and redeem now the human race. I'll explain also in the other chapter how God himself asked Abraham after the child was born, after he made covenant, and then the child was born now. The child called Isaac, the chosen child, was born, and then God also asked Abraham to go and sacrifice this child in the Mount Moriah. And then Abraham believed God, say, okay, I have a covenant with you. If you can tell me to sacrifice the child, I know that you raise the child from the dead, because you say through the seed of this child, all the nation of the earth will be blessed. So I believe you. And that is how Abraham believed God and took his son, take his son to the hill to go and sacrifice him. And then from there, Isaac asked his father and said, I can see the fire and the altar, but where is the lamb? And then Abraham told his son and said, God himself will provide a lamb. The lamb which God provided is Jesus Christ. That is why when John the Baptist saw Jesus Christ, he said, behold, see the lamb of the lamb of God will take away the sin of the world. Hallelujah. So we will continue in the next chapter. I hope you get something today here from it. It's an amazing story. It is so amazing how God loved the human race to come and buy us back with his own bloodshed on the cross of Calvary. Hallelujah. So God bless you. If you are not subscribed, subscribe down below in this channel. I will see you in the next video in Jesus Christ's mighty name. Thank you for watching in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. God bless you and bye in Jesus' name. Amen.